So welcome to this talk, and this talk is all about the shifting of perception which occurs when you unplug from the constant stream of thoughts in the mind, and you bring your awareness to a deeper part of your being, to a deeper level of consciousness. Now usually when this occurs, we try and conceptualize our experiences which lie beyond the thinking mind. We try and conceptualize our awareness of this deeper consciousness so that we can remember it, perhaps share it with others, talk about it, think about it. But the most important thing is that we remain in that space. The most important thing is that we live that way, that we live from a deeper space of consciousness, that our consciousness is expansive and not limited in any way, because this is really what our consciousness needs. It needs to expand and it needs to be free. It's a very creative force, which is powerful beyond all our understanding. All it really needs is to be free. It needs to express itself, just like we do. And it expresses itself in a very creative way. Now, this isn't something we can really understand with our mind, because we don't need more food for our mind, we don't need more mental understanding. We need to move our attention into this deeper space, into this deeper state of awareness where we can feel the creative force flowing through us. So it's not such a cerebral experience anymore, it's really a very intuitive and a very feeling experience. So we're feeling ourselves being animated by this creative force which we call consciousness, which you could also call life. But we feel ourselves moved by this force. We feel deeply creative. In every part of our body, in every cell of our body, we sense this feeling of creativity, this sense of potential, that we have so much potential, so many possibilities for creating and expanding and sharing light and sharing joy, sharing who we are. That there's a deep excitement and a deep sense of purpose to our very being, just to the fact that we are here. And all we really want to do is to be sensitive to this creative force, so that we can know what it is, or know how to channel and how to flow with the direction and the force of this intelligence, this energy, this life, how to follow its lead, and really how to let it express itself through us, how to let this creativity, this creative force express itself through us, without us thinking that we have to work it out or we have to be in control of this process. Because really we're just the receivers, we're just the vessels for this greater consciousness. And we are motivated by its presence in our being to be creative, to be expansive, to be transformational in the way we live our life. But this is a very subtle thing. To be transformational really means to be part of the force which transforms our consciousness, which essentially is consciousness. Consciousness is the transforming force, because when we attend to it, when we give our full attention to consciousness, then we are empowering it. We are merging with it. We become consciousness, or we remember that we are consciousness in a very experiential way. And again, this can't be understood in the mind, because the mind can only know concepts. The mind can't allow us to experience what this truly means. The mind can't do anything except interfere with our experience. It keeps us on the superficial level in our mind. When we want to go below, we want to go deeper, below the surface of this realm of thought, to the space of our heart, to the space of light, of expansiveness, of love. And every part of our being wants to experience this. Every part of our being knows intuitively that it's been designed to house divine consciousness. Our being knows this. And so when it starts to realize that its purpose is being fulfilled, when our being starts to become aware that its full depth is being occupied by consciousness, then we start to almost resonate with its vibration. We start to resonate with its deeply harmonious frequency, because the body just takes on the qualities of this divine consciousness. Our body just resonates to the frequency of the divine consciousness that's coming into us. And so we merge with it. Its frequency becomes our frequency, and our body is transformed. Our body is transformed into that very same essence as the divine consciousness. So this means that we become less dense, we become less heavy, we become more attuned to light, to the frequencies of light. We become more receptive to divine communication, to higher communication, communication that comes from beyond our own small mind, which comes from a greater mind, a greater consciousness, the highest love, which is always trying to share information with us, always trying to share wisdom and light and beauty with us. And all we have to do to receive these things, all we have to do to allow these things to occupy our body and our heart and to shine out through our behavior and our words and our being, all we have to do is allow them to occupy our heart. All we have to do is allow our heart to be open to these beautiful things, these beautiful energies of light and joy, frequencies of kindness, generosity, humility, compassion. Humility is obviously a very important one, because puts us in a position where we are willing to serve others. We are willing to be of service to all those who require our assistance. This is what humility is. It's that willingness to be of service, to serve everything and everyone, all creatures, all creatures who are suffering, all beings in suffering who need help, who request our help, then we feel that it's a privilege to help them. We feel it's an honor and a blessing to be of service. And this is what really transforms our heart into a temple of love, a temple of kindness. Because without this humility, this willing to serve others and help others, then the heart is still more of a selfish entity, and it needs to be a completely selfless entity. It needs to exist for others. Our spiritual heart needs to exist, and it does exist for the benevolence which should be flowing through us.